In October 2012, news made the round world over of a 20-year-old Brazilian girl who put her virginity for auction online to the highest bidder. The bid ended on the 24th day of October that same year, and the highest bidder was a Japanese man who reportedly won the bid at a whopping $780,000. For weeks, this despicable online virginity demolition bid went on. It was shocking to see how unabashed men fought tenaciously to pay such a whopping sum of money just to this virginity 20-year-old girl. What an incredible absurdity. It was also reported that the act was to be consummated aboard a private airplane on a flight from Australia to the United States of America. Her aim, purportedly, was to raise money to help poor families in her community in southern Brazil. It is indeed ludicrous that prostitution could be depicted as a legitimate instrument to help the poor. It was flabbergasting to monitor such online virginity demolition bids, as several men had contended for that outrageous episode of a goofy, contemporaneous prostitution. In this 21st century, absurdity has been subtly repackaged. How sad it is that a 20-year-old girl, devoid of all decency and dignity, will condescend to such level of inanity. But why I recount this sordid report? It is because success is indeed relative and means different things to different people, be it prostitutes, armed robbers, bandits, terrorists, and even despotic and cruel leaders like Adolf Hitler, who only attract bad success to their names. Still on the subject of bad success, let us examine the lifestyle of Adolf Hitler, one of the most despicable and brutal leaders the world has ever known. In many European countries like Germany, Austria, Spain, France, and the Netherlands, the name Adolf, or its translated equivalent, which was a common name in the 19th and 20th century, has since been jettisoned as a popular forename because of the notoriety of the brutish Adolf Hitler, the German butcher behind the Holocaust. Names are very important and significant to the destiny of any individual, people, or nation, be it the name of a person, corporate entity, community, state, or country. It may astonish you to hear that some parents curiously give their children weird names like Violence, Full Stop, Zombie, Facebook, and even Lucifer. Fascinatingly, in the Latin language, the name Lucifer actually means morning star or bringer of light. In New Zealand, for instance, the government's name registrar had to ban parents from giving their children uncanny names like Violence. Anyways, let us get back to Adolf Hitler's dossier. Undoubtedly, one of the greatest vices and consequences of bad leadership in global history was the Holocaust. But surprisingly, as horrific as it was, there are people who are hitherto ignorant about it and others who do not even believe that the Holocaust was a reality despite evidence to the contrary. The word Holocaust is derived from the Greek word holocaustum, which means a completely burnt sacrificial offering, usually offered to a god. In historic terms, the Holocaust was a systematic state-sponsored persecution and extermination of various ethnic, religious, and political groups perpetrated by the National Socialist German Workers' Party, also known as the Nazi Party in Germany, before and during the Second World War. It involved killing squads and concentration or extermination camps with the sole objective of entirely wiping out members of the population considered to be undesirables. Jews all over Europe were the main targets. It is estimated that over 6 million Jews were exterminated in Germany alone. Other undesirables in the population included Jehovah Witnesses who refused to enlist in the German army. Homosexuals and people with various forms of disabilities were also considered as undesirables. Adolf Hitler was born on the 20th day of April in the year 1889 and became the German leader on the 30th of January 1933. Hitler eventually lost touch with reality, becoming obsessed with a devilish ambition to remodel Europe and change world history by creating a master race. He was possessed with a nonsensical notion that he was the savior of the German people. His primary goal was rearmament. His foreign policy was the acquisition of guns. Hitler was a tyrant, a ruthless dictator, and a malicious butcher with an insatiable appetite for genocide, driven by deep hatred. He fought to destroy all the Jews living in Germany by enacting racist laws and eventually by reducing Jews to second-class citizens. Jews were removed from their places of work. Their businesses were boycotted or even taken over by Aryan Germans, and all those Jews who had German citizenships were stripped of their rights. Their children were barred from German schools. When the Second World War began, the oppression of the Jews became a way of life in Germany. What began as a mere oppression eventually burgeoned into the Holocaust, a deliberate and well-orchestrated strategy to eliminate the Jews from the face of the earth. Success for Hitler was to achieve his goal of a so-called perfect race. His priority goal was to annihilate the Jews, not only in Germany, but in Europe as a whole. The Nazis established death camps where millions of Jews were sent to die. The Holocaust was dreadful. About 9 million Jews were massacred across Europe. That's astonishing. Executions were merciless. Babies, young children, women and men were often tortured before being killed. The Nazis were sadistic mercenaries of death. Adolf Hitler was indeed a radical anti-Jew fanatic. His anti-Semitic ideology, which is enunciated in his book Mein Kampf, explains Hitler's passionate goal to utterly destroy the Jews. At the end of the Second World War, Poland alone had lost over 3 million Jews. Hitler had ordered the establishment of 7 concentration or slave labor camps. Hunger and sickness, particularly typhoid fever, was endemic in the camps and were responsible for a large number of deaths in addition to those carried out through systematic extermination. But amazingly, though helping the Jews was punishable by death, some churches and communities succeeded in rescuing and hiding many victims. Eventually, individuals and families also helped to rescue prisoners who were already condemned to death. For many years, these atrocities by a dreadful lunatic went on unabated, with the international community doing nothing to stop them. The Nazis' victimization of the Jews was unjust and cruel. But why have the Jews been such a target of so much hatred and aggression? Nevertheless, as the saying goes, whatever has a beginning must have an end. And so it was. In May 1945, the end of a despicable Nazi butcher came to pass when Russia on one end and the Anglo-American forces on another invaded and captured Germany in May 1945. Unfortunately, Hitler evaded punishment from his victims by committing suicide along with his wife, Eva Braun, on the 29th day of April 1945. Realizing that the war was lost, Hitler purportedly shot himself in his underground bunker while his wife poisoned herself with cyanide. Their bodies were completely burned by Hitler's loyal aides, pursuant to his instructions. It is indeed unfortunate that the Holocaust is not unique in history. There are many despicable leaders who led their people with brutal force and cruelly persecuted their opponents in order to retain power. Joseph Stalin was one of such cruel leaders. He lived from 1878 to 1953. He was a tyrannical leader of the former Union of Soviet Socialist Republic, also known as USSR. It is estimated that Stalin caused the death of over 20 million people. Also, there was Francisco Franco, who lived from 1892 to 1975. He was a Spanish dictator who held on to power from 1939 to 1975, which was a whopping 36 years of terror. His reign saw severe oppression and suppression of his citizens, many of whom were sent to concentration camps and prisons. However, Pol Pot, another brutal leader who lived from 1925 to 1998. He was the Prime Minister of Cambodia, who was the force behind the Cambodian genocide. He led the Khmer Rouge with brutal force and became Cambodia's merciless dictator from 1975 to 1979, a short period of 4 years. He was responsible for one of the worst massacres in modern history, as it is on record that he was responsible for the deaths of over 3 million people who died through starvation, incarceration, forced labor, outright murder. Success for these despicable leaders meant extermination and destruction. Remember the saying that when bad leaders rule, the people perish. That was the case in Uganda when Idi Amin Dada seized power through a coup d'etat in 1971 and became Uganda's self-styled emperor and conqueror of the British Empire. He was the third president of Uganda, and it is reported that Idi Amin was responsible for the deaths of over 500,000 people. His dictatorial regime was one of terror, which witnessed unprecedented torture, extrajudicial executions, unprecedented corruption, and persecutions. He ruled from 1972 to 1979 and went into exile, where he passed away in the year 2003. It is apposite to avow that the success he attained by becoming a military president regrettably became a nightmare for most Ugandans during his era as military president. Ever heard about Mao Zedong? Leaders like Adolf Hitler, Idi Amin Dada, Joseph Stalin, and Saddam Hussein are better known. Mao Zedong was a Chinese Marxist who led the Chinese Cultural Revolution. He was chairman of the Chinese Communist Party from 1945 to 1976. He was a pathological killer who ruled China with an iron fist. His atrocities led to the deaths of over 70 million people, which makes Adolf Hitler and other loathsome leaders look like kindergarten players in the theater of dreadful leadership. How about François Duvalier, who lived from 1907 to 1971? He ruled Haiti from 1957 to 1971. He is one of history's despicable leaders whose ruthless leadership style immortalized him for his nauseating reign of cruelty, terror, and oppression. It is recorded that he was responsible for the assassinations of over 30,000 Haitians. It is outstanding to imagine how despots create goals to destroy many lives. Evil people with devilish ambitions derive satisfaction by eliminating fellow human beings. It is unfathomable that success for some would entail the deaths of others. There are more examples, such as the case of a despicable leader called Augusto Pinochet. He lived from 1915 to 2006. He was a military dictator who came into power through a coup d'etat in 1973 in Chile and ruled for about 20 years. He brutally suppressed all opposition to his reign of terror. Pinochet suffered a heart attack on the 4th day of December in the year 2006. A vile leader he truly was. There was a leader called Mengistu Haile Mariam, who was born in 1937. He came into power in 1974 and became Ethiopia's communist dictator until 1991, when he fled to Zimbabwe. During his era of leadership, he launched a campaign called the Ethiopian Red Terror that was responsible for about 1.5 million deaths. Mengistu Haile Mariam was sentenced to death in absentia by Ethiopia's High Court that overturned his previous life imprisonment sentence. Saddam Hussein is reported to be another cruel leader whose success goal entailed oppression and death. He lived from 1937 to 2006. He became the president of Iraq in 1979. He was ostensibly responsible for over 500,000 deaths, many of whom were Kurds. He was a brutal dictator who was ousted by the US and the UK-led coalition forces in the year 2003. He was eventually sentenced to death and executed by hanging on the 30th day of December in the year 2006. What a way to be remembered. Indeed, bad success always leaves a sour taste in the mouth. Ever heard about Charles Taylor? Born in 1948, he was a former president of Liberia who became president in 1997. He was accused of gross human rights violations, war crimes, and crimes against humanity during the civil war with Syria alone. On the 10th day of October in the year 2013, the International Criminal Court found this notorious warlord guilty and convicted him on 11 counts of war crimes in Syria alone. He was sentenced to serve 50 years imprisonment in Britain by the International Criminal Court. His offenses include rape, terrorism, murder, and the use of child soldiers. The list of notorious leaders is endless. It contains profiles of dreadful leaders like Benito Mussolini, a former prime minister and fascist dictator of Italy from 1922 until his death in 1945. He is remembered for establishing the first fascist movement in the world. It is on record that he executed over 300,000 Italians. There was also Fidel Castro, who was a revolutionary politician and former prime minister of Cuba from 1959 to 1976, as well as former president of Cuba from 1976 to 2008. It is on record that he was responsible for the deaths of over 50,000 people in Cuba. For many centuries, Bad leaders have always existed, and many of them reigned with terror and brutal force, oppressing their people. From Herod the Great, who was the unchallenged king of Judea, a position he maintained for 32 years, to the ruthless and notorious Emperor Nero, who was the fifth emperor of Rome from AD 54 to AD 68. Interestingly, one of the most ruthless leaders of all times was a woman called Empress Wu, who was the first and only female emperor in Chinese history and the de facto ruler of the Tang Dynasty from 690 to 705 CE. She was a viciously wicked, sadistic, and sexually depraved dictator who tortured and murdered her people mercilessly. She executed many of her rivals and banished some from China. She executed members of her own family, such as her nieces, nephews, and even her own newborn daughter. She also executed one of her sons and ordered another to commit suicide. She poisoned thousands of her own people, strangled, mutilated, burned, and sometimes boiled many people alive. She often ordered for many of her citizens to have their ears, noses, feet, and legs cut off. She passed away in December 705 CE at the age of 81. It is strange and amazing that wicked leaders oftentimes live very long to oppress their people. While some people aspire to impact humanity positively and successfully, there are those whose goals were or are stared at destroying lives and properties and bringing misery to humankind. Undoubtedly, bad success attracts sorrow and often leads to destruction.